So.
All right, here we
go. For game one, we're going to see, we're going to see the Olimar Ganon and the Daisy Lucina. I'm actually surprised to see Lucina here. I won't lie to you. I think Roy's a better character and also pretty good in doubles as well, but.
There we go. Already starting the match off with a Doria! So it is looking good. Ooh, and a flame choke to boot. Couldn't quite get the tech chase and the handoff, actually. Oh no. We good. Yeah. We good.
Ganon actually, like, his recovery is definitely bad, like, distance-wise, but it's kind of hard. Is that it? Wow.
Oh my god, yeah, sliced off his toes. Give me them toes. There we go.
Oh, but Nuggets right now has a stitch. He's definitely slowing it down so that way he doesn't hit anyone he doesn't want to. He throws it away. Happens.
And I like that. You see, you went for the down turn. Actually went for the nair there, and a lot of other pieces would have thought, oh, like he's too high for me to connect, so I'm gonna go for the up air instead. But Nugget's showing just how comfortable he is with conversion with the character.
Yeah, this is a. I think this could honestly go either way. It just depends on how hard red team traps the blue team. Because that's the one thing that they would have on blue team right now is that they both have super good ledge pressure as characters. They both have super good combo game on blue team. Oh wow, just the run up F smash.
And you see, that was the thing, right? Like, for Pilgrim, it was like, ah, I need help. I need backup. I am getting a float nared by Nuggets over and over as I'm trying to recover low. And we saw that, all right, cool, I'll try to help you. I-5 runs in with a Ganon and ends up losing a stock.
Yeah,
board, right?
There's not much he can do there. Oh, but he up smashed red team and blue team, so maybe the trade will be worth, actually.
Yeah.
Because now red team is down to their 4 stocks. Kuma's on his last stock. Nugget's stock taken right now, 165 on his first stock, but blue team both on their second stock. At pretty low percents.
And that's the one thing they need to look out for, both members of the blue team, but especially I-5 has to watch out for that falling up air from Lucina. That will convert into so much damage and likely a Ganon off stage. The moment you do that, you have arguably his weakest point in the game, so you're going to need to make sure that you're staying on stage, you're looking out for that conversion tool, and already you can see I-5 charging in at 120-something percent, that's kind of easy. There's not really much I-5 can do there to mix up the recovery. Maybe recover super high.
Ooh, nice. He's catching them with a run-up up air, which is just way better than Smash 4 now. It's super good. It's just a good approach option. But this is a scary position because now one rainy F smash from I-5 could just take the stock from any either of the red team. And Kuma's at a fairly high percent right now, so this is just definitely scary. In a few more percent, he could just get up thrown by Pilgrim, or he could just get up aired off stage from I-5.
Yeah, and I-5 even can just kind of wait for something to be unspaced, especially in doubles, and just go for an up smash out of shield. One up again is better off without a shield. Oh my goodness, he's dead.
It's dead. That's just unlucky.
It's so hard to deal with this Ganon. You can't air dodge there. You're going to die anyway, and now he's going to get abused for a while off stage. Pilgrim trying to make something happen here, though. Won't find it, and Excelsior!
Thundercats!
Ho! Oh! You know, there's only so much you can do, right? We had a Nuggets covering the neutral getup and, you know, pretty much any other option from there, right? If he wants to do a ledge getup, he's covering that too. Getup attack, he can shield. And even if he doesn't shield it, he does have...
he broke out of jail!
Oh, God. Late is free.
Late is free. Free my boy Late. Free my boy Late.
Free Late. If y'all don't know, aside to the players on the screen right now, Kool-Aid apparently has been in jail, or at least that's what Airbnb thinks.
Yeah.
He's been serving a 14-year-long sentence since he was 11 years old, so we're happy he was able to kind of get some probation time and come out to Ultimania to kind of play with the boys before he has to go back to jail.
Yeah.
And hopefully we'll try to get a GoFundMe to pay for the bail, but Kool-Aid having a time.
I need an F in chat for my boy Kool-Aid.
Oh, yeah, lay it out. You know, you thought Mango was bad being in jail. Kool-Aid, he's the next coming. He's been there long before.
Apparently. But for game two, I don't think we're going to see any switches here, which I don't think so. But I think we can see some adaptation from Pilgrim I-5 here. Because game one was definitely, like, pretty close. It's just that every single time I-5 was offstage, Kuma knew what to do and just dropped down, fared him super low, and was able to save the day.
And that's the biggest thing I'm worried about as well. If you are the blue team right now, you need to imagine this is, you know, you're in elementary school, third grade, and you're going on a field trip, right? And your chaperone tells you buddy system. They're not allowed to be more than a few character lengths away from each other, or else it's going to be a bad time. There's a lot of times in that first match where we saw it become a one-player game on somebody's end, right? Where it'd be like, oh, crap, I-5 is getting edgeguarded, and Pilgrim's all on the other side of the stage. He can't do anything to support him. Same thing for Pilgrim, getting nared by Nuggets, couldn't do anything. They need to be close closer to each other where they can help each other out in scenarios like this where they're getting edgeguarded by someone from the red team.
Yeah, it's just they have to try to play closer to each other, but Daisy and Lucina just have the options to wall each other out and separate them. It's super hard. It's just they could find ways for it, but I think Kuma and Nuggets have the download already.
Oh, he just downed the Pikmin.
He annihilated that Pikmin. That was rough.
That Pikmin never had a chance, man. Straight to the Shadow Realm. I'm going to go ahead and chill there.
He deserved it. He deserved it.
Probably with Merrick and whoever else is chilling down there now, man.
But right now, this is blue team down two stocks right now. Oh, Lucina too low? All right.
Okay, so we'll take it, man.
We'll take those. And Nuggets at 168 right now. That's just one free up throw. Oh, has him off stage. No punish there.
And this is so terrifying. You're seeing i5 having to play up against Kuma. And it's really just hard. All he has is that Nair to afford a neutral or like an instant dash attack to try and trade with the safe retreating forwarders, retreating neutral airs that we're seeing often time and time again from Kuma.
And that was a nice down B. That was a nice Wizard's Kick from i5, because the thing that changed about it in this game is that now there's just no sour spot on the move ever.
Mm-hmm.
So even at the very end, it'll just be the normal sweet spot and just kill you for it. You won't even expect it. You have to actually respect it now. And two stocks apiece. Oh, sorry, I'm lying. i5 down to his last stock. This is he's playing off stage right now, which is a super scary position for him to be in.
Oh my god.
Yeah. And they're both being super oppressed right now.
He almost had that forward smash as well, but the falling up air came out just fast enough. But here we go, that's what I'm talking about. We know Purple's going to get beat up here. Well, as I say that, we're going to see actually the drop of the, it looks like the back air from Kuma to give Pilgrim a second chance. But it doesn't matter, Kuma is gone and 100% on i5. i5 needs to stay in the center of the stage as long as possible or have Pilgrim be his mission impossible. We need to be back to back. And as I say, almost losing the stock, the down tilt, not quite connecting to the forward air, but i5 is being cornered. Beautiful back air from i5 though to keep this a little bit closer of a game.
Yeah, i5 is definitely at a super scary position right now. He has to put in as much work as he can, but also at the same time do it safely, which is something that Ganon isn't super known for.
Oh my God.
Down air? He wanted the nair there. Ooh, catching all three of them with the Dancing Blade.
Saying Sword Rain is coming into full effect here.
This is definitely a hard position for i5 to be in, because now he's at ledge versus Lucina, and it's just a painful spot to be in. Wants to catch him with that out in smash? Nah, not going to get him. And now 3-1 for blue team versus red team. And Pilgrim's good for that. Pilgrim definitely knows his, definitely is good attacking. He plays a character with a super bad recovery, so he has to at least learn it.
Right, similar to all Foxmans, right? You can't be a Foxman and not know how to tech. People trying to stage spike you every day of the week. He's trying to get the KOs here. Has 3 stocks to work with.
Won't
find it. A beautiful dolphin slash from Kuma, though. Mm-hmm. Sealing the stock with a beautiful finish there. So. Yeah. Moving on further in bracket, we're probably going to have a winner's round 3 now. I don't really know. At this point, there shouldn't be any round 2 matches really left. Yeah.
There's a few. Yeah.